The Lighting Research Center at Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute has created a free online calculator to help compare horticulture luminaires. We thank the sponsors of the project, Natural Resources Canada and the Lighting Energy Alliance. The calculator is based on the Horticulture Luminaire Evaluation Framework described in this report, which is available on the LRC's website. Throughout the website, hover over any text with a dotted underline to bring up tooltip help. To use the calculator, sign up for an account or sign into an existing account at the top right of the page. Sign-in is required because any luminaires you choose to upload, information about your growing application, and your results will all be saved in a database so you can access it on future visits. None of this information is accessible to other users. You will need to provide your email address and a password to sign up. You may also choose to provide your name and organization. We may use this information to communicate with you about this calculator, but your information will not be shared with other organizations. Once you've signed up, click on the Calculator menu button. The calculator has three steps, which we'll go through in more detail. First, you'll select the luminaire you want to analyze. Second, you'll provide information about your growing application, such as economics and target light levels. And third, you'll view the results. The first calculator step is to select your base case and upgrade case horticulture luminaires. The base case represents the existing luminaire in the grow facility and used only for an economic comparison. In other words, photometric information about the base case isn't provided in the results. The upgrade case luminaire is the luminaire you're considering installing. You'll receive economic and photometric results about this luminaire on the results page. Several horticulture luminaires are provided with the calculator to get you started. These luminaires were tested by the LRC for the study mentioned earlier. Hover over a luminaire to bring up more information about it. To select one of these as the base case, click the Base Case button on its display card. To select another luminaire as an upgrade case, click on the Upgrade Case button on that luminaire's display card. You can use the area on the left to filter the luminaires to help you find the one you're looking for. To add a luminaire that you're considering, click the card that says Add a Private Luminaire. It's called a private luminaire because it will be available to you when you're signed in, but it will not be visible to other users. Some of the information is just to help you find this luminaire among the others available and to document the information on the results page. Other information affects the calculations. For example, if the luminaire has any replaceable components, such as lamps and drivers, you'll enter information about those components on the application page. Whether the luminaire is linear or nonlinear, such as rectangular, will affect the maximum number of luminaires that can fit into the grow facility to meet the target light levels. You'll need the luminaire's Ies file and a spectral power distribution, or SPD file. You can get these from a photometric testing laboratory or request them from the manufacturer. The Ies file must be in the standard format specified by the IESNA, and the file must have a .ies extension. The SPD file must be a tab-delimited text file with wavelength in nanometers in the left column and emissive power, either relative or absolute, in the right column. The SPD file must have a .txt extension. If you have the SPD data in a spreadsheet, first, delete any header text, then choose Save as a tab-delimited text file. After creating the new luminaire, find it on the luminaire selection page and choose it as the upgrade or base case. Click the button that says Next Step Application to proceed to the second calculator step. In this step, you'll provide information about your growing situation. The calculator assumes that the growing area is 30 by 36 feet and that the crop fills the entire area. First, choose the mounting height above the plant canopy. If you're able to adjust the mounting height, the calculator will analyze mounting heights from 1 to 8 feet and identify the most efficacious height for the luminaire you selected. Otherwise, enter your fixed mounting height. If you choose to find the optimum height, it will take longer for the results to be processed because more calculations are needed. Next, provide the PPFD and lighting operating hours per day. PPFD is photosynthetic photon flux density. It's analogous to a luminance for people. The PPFD and operating hours together determine the daily light integral, or DLI, which is provided here as a convenience. The higher the PPFD, the more luminaires that will be required and the more expensive the installation will be. Professor Eric Runkel of Michigan State University provides a guide for the minimum DLI needed by various crops. Next, provide the cost of electricity, inflation rate, and the period that the luminaires will be maintained. During this period, it is assumed that if any luminaire or component fails, it will be replaced. Next, provide information about the base case and upgrade case luminaires you selected. The fields on the left are for the base case, and the fields on the right are for the upgrade case. The material cost of the luminaire includes the initial lamp and driver or ballast. If the base case luminaires are already installed, then set its material and labor costs and rebate to zero. If a luminaire has replaceable components, then provide information about its replacement lamps or LED modules, drivers or ballasts, and reflectors. If the luminaire you selected is integrated, you will see an indicator that the input for the components is not applicable. If you've made any changes on this page, scroll to the bottom and click Save the application and calculate results. It may take several minutes to perform the photometric simulations of the grow facility. The results will appear on the page automatically. There's no need to refresh the page. It's okay to close the browser window and return later to the results page by clicking on the Step 3 button at the top of the page. The results page starts with the upgrade case luminaire you selected. This page can be thought of as a sort of spec sheet for that luminaire. Throughout the page, inputs are documented on the left and results are reported on the right. Photometric information about the luminaire is shown at the top of the page. Phi P% is the fraction of photons that are emitted in the photosynthetically active wavelengths. PSS is a measure of the impact of the SPD on the phytochrome. Photosynthetic photon flux, or PPF, is analogous to luminous flux, or lumens, in lighting for people. Here you see the total PPF and broken down in wavelength ranges. KP is the luminaire efficacy. Next, you see a graph of the spectral power distribution, or SPD. Next, you see a chart of how this luminaire compares with the others tested by the LRC for the study mentioned earlier. The upgrade case luminaire is shown with a larger red dot. The other luminaires are shown with smaller gray dots. The farther to the right the dot is, the more flux the luminaire emits. The higher the dot, the more efficacious it is. Below that is a graph of the intensity distribution from the data in the Ies file. Below that is a heat map of the PPFD on a grid that's 4 feet by 4 feet, divided up into 100 cells. This is the PPFD that would be produced by one luminaire mounted at the height indicated in the title. As with the intensity distribution above, this gives a graphical indication of how the light is dispersed from a single luminaire. Next, the luminaire system application efficacy, or LSAE, results are shown. If you selected a fixed mounting height for your application, it will show the results for that height. If you chose to find the optimum mounting height, it will show results for mounting heights from 1 to 8 feet. LSAE describes the useful photons in the entire greenhouse divided by the total power into the electric lighting. It's calculated by totaling the PPFD in areas where it is at least 60% of the target PPFD. The higher the LSAE, the better. The mounting height with the greatest LSAE is marked in green. The LSAE calculation is based on uniformity across the grow facility. If you plan to use the luminaire for non-uniform lighting, such as hanging a linear luminaire close to a crop row, then LSAE may not be a suitable metric for you. The table shows how many luminaires are needed to meet the target PPFD and uniformity criteria at a given mounting height. If the maximum number of luminaires that can physically fit in the greenhouse still can't meet the target PPFD, then this is noted in red. For non-linear luminaires, the maximum number is determined by the length and width of the luminaire as coded in the Ies file. For linear luminaires, the calculator will increase the number of rows of lights to a maximum of 18, and then use the length of the luminaire from the Ies file to determine how many luminaires can fit in each row. Next, the average achieved PPFD is shown, and finally the uniformity is shown. This is the minimum PPFD anywhere in the grow facility divided by the average PPFD. Next, you'll find economic results of the upgrade case on the right compared to the base case on the left. These values are based on the inputs on the application page. You'll find how many luminaires are needed at the height with the highest LSAE, or the maximum number of luminaires that can fit in the greenhouse if the target PPFD wasn't achieved. The initial hardware cost is just for the initial luminaires with no labor. The labor cost is for installing the luminaires initially, then the lighting power density, then the annual lighting energy used and its cost, then you'll see the total cost of ownership. This is the total cost of the luminaires, installation labor, electricity, replacement costs, and cleaning costs over the period that the luminaires will be maintained. Below this is a graph of these cumulative costs over time. If the upgrade luminaire has a lower cost of ownership than the base case at some point, then the time needed to achieve this is shown as the payback period. We hope that you'll find the calculator useful as you evaluate horticulture luminaires for your growing application. If you have any issues with the calculator, please send us an email by clicking on Contact.